Hey, what's up guys? Greg from 412 Balls. Well, today I'm going to go over some more of the collection and probably some more of the holdbacks and stuff I've hatched out over the last year or so. And then at the end, I'm going to go ahead and show you a little project. I'll show you a little picture of the project I'm going to hopefully go through in the next couple months, because this guy, he's going to be a handful. Anyway, stay tuned. We're going to start looking at some snakes. This is a little double het clown hypo girl I picked up. She is always very, for the better term, angry. This girl strikes more than I can shake a stick at. But she is, for the most part, very good feeder. She eats all the time. So I'm just going to go ahead and show you her. I'm going to put her back and grab someone else, because like I said, she is not a friendly girl. Alright, I'll be back with another. We have my clown head hypo male that I picked up. Now this guy, hopefully will be going to that little girl when she grows up. I can get some hypo clowns out of the mix. As you can see, I love this guy's pattern. I don't like the really reduced clowns. Actually, I like seeing some pattern on them. You know, the sides here. I mean, don't get me wrong, the reduced ones are nice, but I like the busy pattern on them. And he doesn't want to stick in the camera here, so I'm going to go ahead and put him back in. Hopefully you're seeing him. Let me get this light in here a little better. Alright. Here he is. Alright, let me put him away and I'll grab someone else. A bamboo enchi male. He does have a little bit of stuck shed here. Doesn't look like he got it all off. So he may be going in for getting a soak here soon. But he was bred to a pastel calico female this year. Unfortunately, doesn't look like... I mean, she laid 10 eggs. I've already lost probably half the clutch. I don't know if it was just he was a young male and the eggs weren't, the veins on some of them weren't very strong, but unfortunately that happens. Like I said, you can see some of the stuck shed here. I'm going to work on getting that off them. Don't mind me, it's hot in here and I am sweating. Alright, let me go grab another one. Alright, this is my champagne banana male. And he had an issue where he was rubbing his head. As you can see, he's got a little dark spot here. I have since switched him over to another tub. And he's healing up fine. This guy bred my Lemon Blast female and also a Pastel 8 Ball, although I think only the Lemon Blast is going to go this year. So we'll see what we get out of that clutch, but As you can see, he has the flecking here, the little black specks. Some people think sometimes that they're, if they only see a couple of them, they think they're mites, but that's just part of the banana. As you can see down his dorsal here, he does have some pattern from the champagne. I just love, I mean, I don't know if the camera's picking it up, but I just love his color. Oops, sorry, buddy. All right, let me put him back and grab someone else for you. All right, this is my Savannah male. I hatched him out myself. Savannah is your Mojave cinnamon. And here's another one. I mean, I have them in this Freedom Breeder rack. I'm using the coconut husk bedding. But, unfortunately, I'm getting some shedding issues. Now, I did just recently pick up a humidifier, so hopefully that's going to stop. I'll have this room pretty humid at all times. So that should stop this sheds from happening like this. But this guy also went this year. He was bred to a pastel mystic. He bred a pastel mystic, that is. Nobody wants to cooperate here today. Sorry about that. Come here. Get in the camera. But I love this guy's pattern. To me, this is how a Savannah should look. I love how all those alien heads just come together. Hopefully you're seeing that. I know I got some shadows here today, I believe. I got to work on this lighting. And this guy, I've since sold the father, or the sire, of the clutch that I got him out of, but he has faint striping along the eyes there. Come on, stay still. But it is a lot washed out like his father. I love his coloration. Alright, let me stick him back. Here's my lesser cinnamon girl, or I'm sorry, lesser Mojave girl. She's another one. She's a striker. She never likes to be messed with too much here. But she is a very nice looking snake. I hatched her out myself last year. Love these blue eyes. I don't know if you're catching that. Let's see. She's gorgeous. And since she isn't the lesser, you don't have to worry about those small eyes or the other issues sometimes you get with the lesser to a lesser combo. And with the Mojave, like, she'll never throw anything but a Mojave or a lesser. So that's the great thing about the Superform here. But I just love her. She's, you know, again, I love all my snakes, but this girl's beautiful. If you like the all-white snakes. And she's getting away. So I'm going to put her back and grab someone else. All right, well, that's all the snakes I'm going to show you today. As you can see, it's hot in here. I'm sweating. But anyway, I'll show you a little snap, a little picture I took of a little ongoing project I'm going to be having here. What I'm trying to do is picked up years ago now from my oldest daughter a California king snake. She named him Cal. Cal is, well, let's just put it this way. Cal has never met anybody he hasn't bitten. I'm going to try to break him of that, so this is going to be one of those deals where you might be seeing some blood every now and then, and it's probably going to be mine. Most likely it will be mine. So we'll see how this goes, and you guys have a great night. Talk to you later. Bye.